So let's just start at the beginning. What's the significance of Juneteenth becoming an official and the latest federal holiday?
Well, it's the story of how Gordon Granger, U.S. Army General, announced on June 19, 1865, that slavery was over in Texas. And it's significant to have a day of remembering emancipation join other federal holidays that we have to talk about the importance of this topic. And it's an opportunity for people to reflect on that. So making it a national holiday, something that everybody celebrates, not just Texans, is a way of bringing that story and the story of enslaved people into closer focus. And also, I should say, the aftermath of slavery and the struggle that African Americans have still been on from those days until today.
Mm-hmm. Tell us about Opal Lee. She's a daughter of Texas. She fought to make Juneteenth a federal holiday. She was honored by the President of the United States, who got down on bended knee during the ceremony to talk about it. You were in the room. So put us in the room. Tell us about yesterday, but also tell us about Opal Lee.
Okay. Well, you know, I got the invitation yesterday in the morning to come down to the ceremony. And one of the first things that I thought was, what about Miss Lee? Will she be able to make it? I mean, it's one thing for me to hop on the shuttle and get down to Washington. But I, you know, was wondering if she would be able to make it, because this in some ways, in many ways, was really her day. And I was there in the audience, and they, near the time that the president was supposed to, and the vice president were supposed to come out, they brought an extra chair and put it in the row right in front of mine, right, you know, very close. And then she walked in and sat down, and I felt really good because I've gotten to know her over the course of doing, you know, talking about my book. We've done a couple of events together. Indeed, we'd done an event the day before, I should say. And we were talking about, you know, what was happening, the Senate vote and so forth. And we'd known each other before then. And we discussed this topic, thinking about when might it happen. I don't think either one of us thought that it would happen so quickly. And so when she came in and when the president recognized her and had her come up when he signed the bill and gave her a pen and everything, it was just it's a wonderful thing. I had asked her, you know, how did you get involved in doing this? And she's 94 years old. And she said, well, when I was about 89, and then of course I just, you know, I want to stop you right there. When you're 89, I want to get to 89. And then I want to be the kind of person who starts on a quest at 89. And, you know, she, you know, gathered lots of supporters, and she did, you know, walkathons, all those kinds of things at her age, to promote this notion. And then she got to sit there in the White House that day and bask in the glory of everybody, just warm feelings towards her and standing ovations. It was just a really festive, very, very warm day.